Hello, sales team. What I want to do for you right now is do a side-by-side comparison of the Restore versus the Meditub. It's a very popular unit, really big in the south central states like Texas and so forth. But we're also going to point out the similarities between the Meditub and SafetyTub and American Standard. Very similar models versus the features and benefits of the Restore. Okay, so let's get going. The first thing, let's just look at the two products side by side and see what the visual differences are. What jumps out at you? I know one of the first things I notice is the towel bar on the Restore. It's a nice handy feature. You can put your cloth there and have a nice place to keep it out of the way. No such bar with the Meditub nor on the SafetyTub. The other things that jumps out to me is the nice clean panels of the Restore, which is in keeping with design tastes today, versus this wave pattern you see on the Meditub, which is okay, but in design circles might be considered a little dated. But let's move on to the more physical characteristics, the differences between the two products. When we look at the gel coat itself, the Restore product, as we learned earlier, is a hand-applied gel coat done in two layers. And that's how we have the durability and the luster. When we take a look at the Meditub unit, this is a sprayed-on gel coat, and because of that, it doesn't have quite the same luster and not quite the same thickness. And that's also true of the SafetyTub and the American Standard. Now let's take a look at the doors, particularly the top of the doors. If you recall with the Restore, we pointed out that we have a contoured door, which is great because that allows you more space to enter the unit. And once you've sat in the unit, you have more space to clear your knees when you close it. Now let's take a look at the Meditub door. As you can tell, it's pretty much a straight up and down door, slight angle to it, but you don't have that additional space. So in comparison, the Restore unit's 17 inches across the top, the Meditub's about 15, and you don't have that same knee clearance. And that is also, it makes quite a difference, especially for people with a little longer legs. Now let's talk about the locking mechanisms. If you recall with the Restore, our handle had a dual point locking mechanism, two cams, so that both the top and the bottom of the door are firmly locked in place. Not so with the Meditub. There's one single point locking mechanism, and that is the same case with the SafetyTub and the American Standard. Just one single locking mechanism. Now, when we talk about other hardware, if you recall with the Restore, we have the stainless steel two-part hinges. Those were really cool because they allowed us to easily remove the door for cleaning and so forth, and if it ever had to get repaired. Very simple to remove that door. When we look at the Meditub sample, it's a very different hinge. The Meditub hinge is what you call a piano hinge, and it's basically connected all the way top to bottom. The problem with it is it makes it very difficult to clean and to repair. Certainly very difficult to get this door off if you ever needed to remove some type of soap scum and so forth. It's the same type of hinge, that piano hinge, that you find on the SafetyTub and on the American Standard units. In terms of the bathing well, inside of this, they both have seats, but the Restore seat is a little taller, 17 inches in height, which meets ADA approval. The Meditub is 16 inches in height. Inside the bathing well, the design is a little different. The Restore has a lot more space for you to stand up and shower. For instance, ample space, and ample space to clear my knees. Not so with the Meditub. When you sit in here, I really have to maneuver to get my knees out of the way, and there's not nearly as much space for me to stand up. Both tubs have a textured floor to avoid slipping, but the Restore also has a slight texture on the seat because you can slip in your seat as well. That's not the case with the Meditub, nor the American Standard and Safety Tub. The Restore also has a contour to the seat, so it kind of cradles you, makes it a little bit more comfortable. When we look at the Safety Tub, the American Standard Tub, and the Meditub, it's a very flat seat. No contour, not quite as comfortable. Now, while I close this up, I wonder if you can recall what we said about our on and off switches. Well, if you remember, we have both of our switches, in this case for the Whirlpool and the air bath, can be turned on without a great deal of dexterity. You don't have to be able to push a button. You don't have to be able to use your fingers. And that's important for a person who, for instance, has arthritis and has difficulty pushing buttons. Ours can be activated with any part of your hand because we have this raised air button for the air bath, which has three speeds, and we have the conductive button for the Whirlpool, which only activates once there's water above the jets and someone's making contact with that water. Now, when we go over to the Meditub, well, both buttons require a finger, and a strong finger at that, because you have to depress these air buttons quite a bit. That's fine for me. I don't have a problem with it, but for an elderly person that has limited dexterity, that can be a challenge. Now, the only thing, other thing I wanted to bring to your attention, it's a little difficult to see here, but the frames. We spoke about the Restore frame, how it is an adjustable 1-inch powder-coated steel frame, and the benefit of that was it's a lot less susceptible to temperature, so you don't have that contraction and expansion as you go from cold to hot. Well, in this case, in the Meditub, what they use is an aluminum frame, which is a lot more susceptible to temperature fluctuations. And the final thing I will point out to you is the access panels themselves. In the case of the Restore, this entire panel can be removed. It's a one-piece panel. What's great about that is you or your plumber has full access to all the plumbing. So should there be any need for repair, you can get to it very easily. The Meditub has two access panels. Here's one right here, and here's the other. And as you can see, you can't quite get to it with the same ease that you can the Restore. Another thing that I'd point out to you is that this panel is held on by magnets, which is very nice now. But as those magnets get weaker, and they will, it'll be a lot tougher to keep that panel in place. So here are some of the differences between the Restore, the Meditub, the Safety Tub, and American Standard. I'm sure you'll see that we have quite a bit of features and benefits that are superior to these products. And the best thing, of course, is that we're priced a lot more economically.